May I first thank thee, the organizers, and the Humboldt Foundation for arranging this conference here in Venice. I'm very grateful for this. I hope to give a very brief talk on this topic, and let me say a preliminary remark. I'm really sorry that people who work on the Kura Araxes culture on the ETC in northwestern Iran did not know of this conference. And so, for example, neither Christian Piller nor Sepi Demasia sent at least a poster to show how the extent of the Kura Araxes culture now in Iran is. I can show you here only a little of this. And my second remark is on the state of research. You all know that the major excavations in northwestern Iran ended in 1978, and since then only very small trial excavations or rescue excavations were performed. And I must say, it is really a pity that one of the most important projects that was undertaken in the late 1970s by the Italian expedition by Pecorella and Salvini at Gitschlar Tepe could not be continued, because that would have shown that the Urmia area is certainly a major area for the ETC, for the Kura Arax culture. They excavated around 10 meters of chalcolithic levels in a trial trench and above 12 meters of Kura Araxes culture. So this would have been a very good place to show the importance of the Kura Araxes culture over there. As I said, the Urmia Basin has been explored by a number of excavations like Geoi Tepe, Yanik Tepe, Haftavan, and Gijla Tepe. And hallmark of all these excavations was the black burnished pottery called Kura Arax or ETC pottery, which has been found as far as the Tehran Plain, the Caspian, even now south of Qom, together with roundhouses at Gian or Godin IV. In all sites, the Kura Arax period ends abruptly. For example, Yanik Tepe and Gitschler are not settled again. Geoi Tepe or Haftavan Tepe go on after some break. But generally the situation is more complex. The terms Early Bronze Age and Middle Bronze Age don't explain all features that have been found through excavations and surveys from Geoi Tepe or Kul Tepe Julfa. For the Middle Bronze Age, only very typical pottery is known, first black on red ware and later polychrome pottery, as I show you here, from Kul Tepe Julfa, first monochrome pottery and then polychrome pottery, like here. I have taken this from a slide of the excavator Akbar Abedi. This is generally the general consensus, that is how the Kura Arax period is followed by the Middle Bronze period. But it's not so easy. The Middle Bronze settlement of Haftavan 6B, defined by its painted pottery, the so-called Van Urmia monochrome and polychrome painted pottery, shows an earlier level, Haftavan 6C, that is mostly neglected in the discussion. The pottery found in Haftavan 6C, according to Charles Burney, was unique for the northern Urmia area. It was a matte black on red painted ware, termed painted orange ware, long before by the Hasanlu project, where this ware was found first in period 7. Burney, also looking at his finds at Haftavan proposed it might be related to the painted pottery of Godin III. What I show you here on the left side is pottery, is black on red or black on orange painted pottery of Haftavan 6C. On the right side you see the famous polychrome vessels from Haftavan 6B then. And what I want to stress especially are rims with a shallow ridge and painted. This is a very distinctive feature of this painted orange ware as defined by the Hasanlu project. And here, let me go to Hasanlu. I show you a plan of Hasanlu 4B, and on the right, an aerial photograph. And it was in the very last campaigns, they did a sounding, a very deep sounding, almost 10 meters below Hasanlu period 5 to reach earlier levels, and somehow they were successful in this. And what I show you here is a very strange, you can say, a very strange publication record. Dyson published, after they did the sounding, he published these notes. He says, the upper strata contained shirts of typical painted orange ware. Designs were cross-hatched, there were bands, there were wavy lines, and he assigned them to a phase of Hasanlu 7A, and below there was a change, there was again cross-hatched painting, and he noted rows of birds, and he called it period 7B, and then, he says, in the lowest level, it disappeared, and they had painted designs consisting of parallel vertical lines interspaced with circles with a dot in the center. This was the publication Dyson did in 1974, and it's very surprising. In 2004, in the Bernie Festschrift, Mary Foyt and Michael Dante and Bob Dyson also wrote a paper on this sounding, but for period 7A and B, not a single painted shirt was published. I don't know what happened. I don't think all the painted shirts went to Tehran. They may have been lost somewhere in the museum, may have been analyzed by another department and never given back. In any case, they are missing from the publication. And what I can show you here are some shirts, some typical painted shirts I found in the Hasanlu archive. On the left side, a nice pot, often published as typical of painted orange ware. You see the cross painting, and you see some bird design. This is from an unpublished tomb, which was attributed to period 7 because of this design. And the other shirts, the pictures are not very good, but you see, for example, you see the painted line on the rim. I have singled out from the photos in the Hasanlu archive. In any case, the description in the Hasanlu project that they found shirts like this is generally correct, even when they are missing from the report in 2004. But let me come to another site. In the same way, it is surprising that the authors of the study stated the painted orange ware is a localized phenomenon restricted to the Ushno-Sulduz and the area southeast of Lake Urmia. Apparently, they were not aware of Bernie's results at Haftavan Tepe, nor had they taken notice of the publication by the Italian expedition on their work in the Oromie Plain. And you see it from the publication if you look for the Pecorella Salvini publication of 1984. It is absent. And what I want to talk about, you know, here the expedition had worked at Gitschler, and they had worked, they had surveyed very carefully Tepe Angene, a site close to the, you can say, to the shore of Lake Urmia. I don't want to suggest that they went there for getting salt from the lake, but it might be a possibility. The Pecorella-Salvini expedition, they published soon afterwards all their results, but their results were or stayed unknown to the Hasanlu excavators. And especially what they found at Tepe Angene, also Kleis was at this site, and both expeditions noted that masses of Kura Arax pottery together with painted orangeware were collected on the surface. This, what I show you here is Kura Arax pottery. You see the typical Narichevan handles, and what I show you here is painted orangeware in the same way as it was found at Haftavan Tepe or in Hasanlu. But this is not all. The Hasanlu project did not care for the survey that Stuart Sweeney had done in 1970 in the southern Urmia area, and he and later Kleis recorded many sites that showed painted orangeware on the surface. I only show here some of these results. First, Siminirut Tepe. You see it on the map here. It's a tepe on the Siminirut, southeast of Lake Urmia. And here again, pottery from this tepe. And again, the really feature is always the painted rims with one dark streak. The next sites I want to show you is near Mahabad, Asir Tepe, painted pottery with painted with the same designs. And the last one I want to show you is Beg Obasi. Beg Obasi is on the very south down here on the Siminirut. And what I want to show on this map is Kura Arax pottery is rare in the southern region of Lake Urmia. Not only Oshnunagade, but also Mahabad, Pirangcha, and especially the Myanduab region show many sites with painted orangeware. More sites can be found on the eastern shore of Lake Urmia. And especially, I want to mention these sites. These sites were already found by Orelstein in 1936 when he did his tour in western Iran. The chronological range is still a matter of debate. The carbon 14 dates from Hasanlu dated to the mixed context with Kura Araxes pottery to the middle of the third millennium. In any case, it may start perhaps at 2700 like Godin III in Godin, and the most northern site is Haftavan Tepe, where this Godin III related ware has been found. And the map I have just shown you gives the impression that painted Urmia ware was, or painted orangeware was, was common and the only one in this area. But I want to show you and just show you another ware that is certainly some centuries older and that was found in the middle, clearly in the middle of the Kura Arax period. It was found in Hasanlu 7C. In the publication, two shirts are illustrated, but I found in the Hasanlu archive, I found some color photos that give you an impression. This is a very fine ware with a very different design, and pieces of this ware were found in Yaanik Tepe II in the middle of the ETC levels. The chart down here shows you where this called Hassan Ali Ware, after the site where Oral Stein found it, was first found. And these are shirts from Hassan Ali. They are really different. This is a fine ware, first found at Hassan Ali and now kept in the British Museum. Here on the left, some drawings of the Hassan Ali ware. On the right, pieces found at other sites, especially in the right upper corner. The piece found at Yaanik Tepe and unfortunately in never again illustrated by Jeff Summers because he thought it intrusive from some later period. And here I show you the chart, a distribution chart for the Hassan Ali ware. It's almost, you can say, almost the same, some differing sites. And from both these maps, we get the impression that the southern Urmia area painted wares were prominent, while in the northern part, Kura Araks and then typical Middle Bronze Age ceramics were common. At the time, it is impossible to say what exact time range is represented by these ceramics. They certainly go on into the second millennium. They have been found mostly on surveys and not in control excavation. And with my last slide, I want to show you, this is a picture of Beg Oversea taken from Google Earth. It might be a good idea, if there's any future chance in Iran, to dig a site like this where all these different painted ceramics are present. Thank you very much.